Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is George, and this is SaaS Master. Today, we're going to check out LiveWebinar. There's a great deal going on, and the link is going to be in the description. Now, LiveWebinar is going to blow your mind away. It's really well thought out. I think it's one of the best tools out there for webinars, and I'm going to show you why that is, because it's so flexible. But let's see, first off, the dashboard. So we have the dashboard right here for LiveWebinar. And the first thing that I recommend is that you set up these basic things before you go ahead and start a webinar. So the first thing I recommend is you head on over to your profile. Obviously, set your avatar, your name, and all that good stuff. Next thing, head on over to recorder settings. Now, here in recorder settings are going to be the place where you're going to set what type of quality you want to send out to your viewers. So you have the frame rate. You have the dimensions, you got up to 1080p. This is gonna depend on the plan you have. Interface language, you have all these languages available already. Video bitrate and all that good stuff. Now in frame rate, it's gonna depend what you're gonna do. So for example, my recommendation, if you're only going to do presentations like PowerPoints, pictures, whiteboards, and that kind of stuff, 12 frames per second is enough. Now, if you wanna do a little bit more dynamic thingy, 24 frames per second is okay. Now, 24 frames per second is used mostly on movies, so it's not like completely fluid, but it's enough. And if you want to look completely fluid, then 30 frames per second will work for you. Next thing you have is a presentation mode that we're going to see in a little bit how that works, but you can set it here by default without having to do it each time over there. And storage providers. So you have these two storage providers, obviously FTP. If you have a hosting plan, you can use that. This is to expand the storage you have available. So instead of storing it here on LiveWebinar, it can go to over there. And personal callbacks, you can set those up. So once you have that set up, then I recommend you head on over to registration forms. Now, registration forms are gonna be used for each webinar. Once you create it, when someone wants to join the webinar, they greet you with this presentation form. Now you can create as many as you want with different type of questions, and I'm gonna show you really quick what that looks like. And if we create a brand new one, let's just say this is a test, and you can, testing, we already have a test, so test two. And placeholder is what type of question are you gonna ask for, like for example, name, obviously, right? New text form, like where are you from? And this is just gonna depend what you wanna ask. Like, what's your email? Where did you find me? What's your browser? It's just gonna depend what you wanna use it for that you're gonna use this registration form and you're gonna create it. Lead forms would be also kind of the same. You just create the form, placeholders, you can make them required or not. Next thing we have is the integration. So you got marketing automation and you can connect these type of accounts there. I already connected MailChimp because when the registration form comes in, I want the email to get registered over there really quick and really fast without having to do it manually. So these are the options that are available right now. You can also use Zapier. You got API credentials and API documentation to help you out with that. So once you have those basic things set up, let's start off with the good part. So this is where you can create your meetings. You can create an instant meeting. Let's just say, hey, you know what? I need to do it right now. Let's just start off. And this could be a meeting, it can be a webinar, or it could be a presentation. You can also schedule the webinar. Let's just say, hey, you know what? Let's just announce it all over the social media accounts. And let's just say it's gonna be like in 7 days or whatever day you set it, date and time, and you can use it that way. In this case, we are going to do an instant meeting because I want to show you what is capable, what it's capable of. So let's start off with a brand new meeting, and you can set all the branding in this. So let's just say I'm ready. And this is how the meeting is going to greet you. This is what you have to do. So first thing you want to do is I recommend that you set up your branding. You can do this after or before, but in this case, we can do it a little bit before. You can see I already have my logo. And that would be right here. So in branding, you can change colors and all those things. So let's just say I'm going to edit this one that I'm actually already working on, and I can move this editor away. And if I hover over anything I want, let's just say I hover here, I get those options to actually edit it. So how cool is that? So I can set a color for this space, a color for this other space. I can change the logo. I can change this look and all those kind of looks. And when I'm ready, I can save it as a default. or I can cancel it, right? So I have this one as default, and I can add more if I want, so I can add a brand new one. Let's just say I'm doing a meeting for this business and then for another, and you can change one with the other. And when you're done branding, you can just close this off. Now, the first and main thing that you want to check out, well, is obviously having your camera and microphone set up correctly. So if I click on this, this will activate the camera. Now we might get like a little weird vortex thingy because I got two cameras, and you can see how that activates. And I'm actually going to mute that audio because it might interfere one with the other. So this is how you would set that up. You can also remove it or leave it like that. If you don't want to do a presentation where you are available, then you just leave it that way. Now, one of the coolest things that I found is that you have separate windows inside of this webinar if you want to use it. So for example, we have this little plus button. Well, this creates windows for you, so you can set up a whole bunch of things. So we have, for example, whiteboard, and you can draw. But let's just say, hey, you know what? I also want to do a YouTube player. So you can put the video right here and have it ready. And I want to share, for example, let's just say storage. Now, storage is where you drop in your files. I really recommend that you load them before you start the presentation, because I'll give you an example. If you load an image and you present it, it's going to be instant, right? You load it, it uploads really quick, and it's loaded. But when you are doing a webinar, a PowerPoint, in this case, I have a PowerPoint or keynote, it takes a little bit longer for it to load. So it uploads and then it kind of like reads it, so it's ready and you can present it as a PowerPoint. You even have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can change pages, go back, and all that good stuff. You can even write on these PowerPoints. So, hey, check this out, man. That's where I want you to see this. So this right here, blah, blah, blah. How cool is that? And what I told you about the windows is that I like so much is that you can switch from one to the other. See these? I'm just dropping one from the other. It can be the camera. I can share screen. In screen, I can share a window, and I can choose this one. And I don't want to create a vortex effect, but you can share that. And like I said, you have these tabs where you can switch one with the other really fast and really quick. Now, like I told you in the beginning, I think LiveWebinar is so well thought out that you have so many options that you can use to actually present a really good webinar or a meeting. Now, you can create call to actions. So for example, if I do a call to action, create one new one, and I can say, hello, send message, like hello, view message for, like constant, seconds, just depends, enable call to action button. In this button, you can say like buy, and you can send like, hey, if you're talking about a product, you can send them to that link right away if you want. That can be an option, and you just send it or preview it. You can also do a test and surveys. You can create one. I already created one. You can just start it off, or you can create as many as you want and just have them ready. This would be really awesome to work one with another. If you have like a co-worker with you, another team member, like make them start sending out the questions, polls, and all that good stuff really fast and really easy, and you keep like doing the presentation. So that's pretty cool. You have a vote manager right here. You can also do video Vimeo player. You can presence manager. You got these other options like broadcast to live streaming. You got Prezi presentations. So if you have Prezi, Prezi is pretty awesome. Those things really move really awesome instead of using PowerPoint. The branding option, closed captioning, and all that good stuff. Now, how cool is that to have these windows there? Now, next thing I want you to take a look at is this right here. So this is the type of meeting that you want to create. Remember, we head over straight to meeting. If we wanted to set this up, we can do this all these things previously. So is this going to be a discussion? So all participants can talk. For larger sessions, up to 25 participants. So 25 people can talk at the same time. I know that would be like pretty crazy. I wouldn't recommend it, but I mean, that's the option. So up to 25 people can talk, the rest will listen. Next thing is presentation. You know what? I'm gonna do a webinar and I'm gonna present this to everyone who's attending. That's the way to do. And you have also question and answers. Question and answers lets you select people if they want to ask something. So you give them the option to let them ask a question, or they ask, hey, can I like jump in and ask something? You can have that option to jump on with the other. So this is pretty cool depending on what you're gonna do. I mean, is it gonna be a meeting? Is it gonna be a webinar? Or is it gonna be a question and answer? Once that's set up, you can have the layout, change layouts if you want, just like switch it up for them. I'm pretty comfortable with the original one, but you can switch it. Next thing we have is right here, you got webinar or meeting interface. So things switch up when you switch one to the other. So if this is like a meeting for your business, then I recommend meeting, right? Because it changes everything and it works with that type of look. We can lock it or unlock this. Let's keep it locked. You can record, you can start, and you got the dashboard information. We got camera. We got participants right here. Depending on your plan is the amount of participants you have available. In this case, I have 500. You can add right here, they start jumping in, and we'll do a test in a bit. And the chat, obviously we got chat. We can send files, voice, or emojis. So let's just invite someone right here. So let's click on invite. We want to copy invitation details. Let's grab this, let's open incognito mode, let's click right there. I should be greeted with the form. Oh wait, I didn't add a form on this one. We'll add a form in a bit. So let's just say, hey, that's me, Max. And request knock, request entry. And what this is going to do, because it's locked, then they have to actually tell me. So I got this right here, and I got this little bell that says, let me in. So I let them in, boom. So I can lock it or unlock it to have it this way. If you wanna have just free people just jump in, just have it unlocked, or if you wanna pre-approve, you use it this way. So I'm going to share this presentation right here, right there, and I should be able to see it in the other incognito mode. Let me show you that, there we go. So this is what the other participant is going to view. I don't have the camera activated. If not, they would be able to also see that. So you can present and they can see everything that's going on in live mode. I don't wanna go too extensive right here because I don't wanna interfere with the presentation I'm doing. All right. So once that's there, how awesome is that to have all those options in a meeting or a webinar that you have right there? Let's see what else we got. So here in Room, we can also schedule the webinar. Now, schedule webinar is what I would recommend to anyone. Obviously, you get prepared. You can set up everything that you want. So in this case, it would be like test three. In this case, when is it going to be? So it's gonna be the 29th. It's gonna start off at 10:30 a.m. And duration of this meeting, well, it's going to last about 1 hour, all right? And set up the time zone. This is really important because that's how the time is going to be based on. You can allow them, so strict event, you can allow them or not. Have that, permanent open room if you want to have it all the time. Event agenda, so like 10 minutes, talk about me, 10 minutes about program, blah, 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 and just whatever you want right there. Set up registration, you want a registration form, remember I told you? So in this case, I already set one up, which is the basic sign up. Remember we had those created over here. If you don't wanna use one of those, you can create one right here. So design new registration form. Lead forms also, if you wanna have that activated, also already have that set up, you can also create one. Presenters, you can add them right here if you have presenters already added, or you can change presenters over here. Let me show you really quick. Over here in details, from attendee, I can send them to presenter or moderator. How cool is that? Even from there. If not, you can do it from after over here. Then you have tracking. If you want to set tracking pixels, so you got Google Pixel and custom tracking pixels. Pixels are pretty awesome if you want to track your users to do remarketing. Well, what is a tracking pixel? Let's just say you attended this webinar and you're selling kids' toys, right? And what happens is that when you're on Facebook, you start seeing branding, you start seeing ads from the webinar you just saw or the toys you presented because you actually track them. Or if it's Google, you would see them in Google search or Google's pages that are affiliate to them and all that good stuff. and you got advanced right here. So in advanced, you said what type of webinar. Remember we talked about, is it gonna be question and answers? Is it gonna be meeting? Is it gonna be webinar? Attendees will enter waiting room or they will go straight. Do you want a password protected? Do you want to create a token protected your room? Do you want to send a thank you to attendee after event has ended? So if you want to do that and set a link to it to the, let's just say you're selling a product, when the meeting is over or webinar, it goes to that link. So that's pretty cool if you're doing this, if sales, or is it going to be something that, hey, you're selling like this ebook and you go sign them up later and all that good stuff. Room layout, you can set it for this one. Room template, you have the files that you want to have them ready. Widget banner image, if you want to use that. I don't want to use that. And you can schedule it. Let's see if I can schedule it right now. Yeah, everything should be set up. Let me show you what this happens. So now that it's scheduled, we can edit it, we can embed it. So let's just say you have your own website and you get the HTML code. Let me click on that. You can get the HTML code and you can embed it over there on your site and it'll look professional. You can have it hosted Architect Box or send the code to developer and they take care of it. Hey, you know what? There it is. You can edit everything you want, and after you create it, you get these three links. So you can send these links to presenters from there. So let's just say you have three people who you're going to be presenting this webinar with. You send them this link. So that just signs them up straight to presenters. Moderators for team members, and you got attendees right here. So the attendees would be the general public that you're going to be inviting. So let's just say you're on the social media and you give them that link so they actually go to the sign up form. So that's how cool this is. Now, if you have the option and if you have the type of plan that gives you sub accounts, it gives you the ability to create sub accounts on your account because you want to separate businesses. For example, you got different businesses, you got different foundations or whatever that you have, you can separate it that type of way because you would have it set up differently, different brandings, different forms, different whatever, you would have it there instead of having everything like messed up in one single place. Storage, remember we told you about loading before starting the presentation, you do that right here. Storage is gonna depend on the plan that you have, and you can also connect it, remember, on the settings for different type of storage. Tests and surveys, and statistics and reports. So once you are launching webinars and meetings and all that good stuff, you have events and sessions and phones bridge. There's so many things that you can do right here that it's super hard to cover it in one single video. But I think the like broad thing that I wanted to show you is well there. It's there. Because you have all the information that it's so flexible. You can do meetings and webinars that are so cool and so flexible that I recommend this software. It's Live Webinars. If you guys want to grab the deal that's going on, please check out the link in the description. And well, that's about it. This is a really awesome software. Just if you guys want to buy it, go ahead and go for it. All right, guys, my name is George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.